How's it going, guys? I'm Theo Joe, and today's topic is going to be 32-bit versus 64-bit, whether it's Windows or programs you're running on Windows or even any other operating system. What are the differences between these? Should you use one or the other? Are there advantages and disadvantages to both? So let's go over that. Now, the first thing to understand is that when it comes to talking about a CPU, the 32-bit versus 64-bit distinction has to do with the register of the CPU, which is basically how much data it can queue up to process at once. 64-bit can process a lot more information and take a lot more information from the RAM to do stuff with than a 32-bit CPU or operating system can do. But one important thing to also know is that every single bit is not directly proportional. So it's not like 64-bit can handle twice as much information or twice as much RAM. In fact, it's exponential. So a 32 gigabit operating system can only handle 4 gigabytes of RAM maximum. And that also means that each individual program in Windows typically was limited to only 2 gigabytes of RAM for each program. Whereas if it's 64-bit, the theoretical maximum for how much RAM you could use is literally over 16.7 million terabytes. And also that 2 gigabyte limit is gone with 64-bit, and Windows allows you to assign literally terabytes to any individual program. So there's really no limit to the amount of RAM you're gonna ever use, even in the foreseeable future. So that is one main advantage that most people can recognize and appreciate, because even if you don't know much about computers, you probably know what RAM is and that more is better. And if there's a 4 gigabyte limit, I mean, that's how much we have in our smartphones these days. That's nothing. So you want a lot more than that. But in addition to that, because the register is wider, it means it can not only use more RAM total, but it's also gonna be able to use that RAM more efficiently. So even if you did still only have 4 gigabytes of RAM, then it would still be able to use that RAM a lot better, so it's gonna be faster in two aspects. So that has to do with the physical architecture of the CPU. You can have 64-bit processors, which are pretty much all of them these days, versus the old 32-bit, but just because a CPU is 64-bit, you can also install a 32-bit operating system on that. It's not exclusive. You wouldn't really wanna do that, but you can if you have to, and you can also obviously install a 64-bit operating system, which is probably what you're using if you've installed Windows in the past few years. And one advantage in 64-bit versions of Windows, at least over 32-bit, is it does have a lot more security features. So I don't know if this was impossible to do on 32-bit or if they just decided to enforce it with 64-bit because driver manufacturers would have to be rewriting drivers for 64-bit anyway, so they may as well force them to do this stuff along the way. But regardless, there are improvements with 64-bit. So this includes, for example, driver signature enforcement. So if a manufacturer wants to write a driver for their device to work with any computer, then they have to sign that driver, which wasn't necessarily required before. So Windows basically says, all right, since you're gonna have to be writing 64-bit processors, they all have to be signed. We're not gonna let any drivers that are 64-bit onto this computer unless it is signed. So that means that it's a lot harder for malware to get onto the computer, because if it's not correctly signed by a legit manufacturer, then somehow that malware would have to bypass that, and Windows would recognize, wait a minute, this isn't from a real manufacturer, and probably block it. Also, 64-bit version of Windows has what is called patch guard, which basically prevents programs and drivers from patching or modifying the kernel, which is basically the core of the operating system. You don't really want programs to be able to do that, so that's one major advantage of Windows 64-bit. And then finally, another advantage is hardware data execution prevention, which is a fancy way of saying that the operating system can block malicious programs from modifying RAM data that it's not supposed to be able to do and stop things from executing that is not meant to be. And kind of as I said before, pretty much all installations of Windows these days are gonna still be 64-bit. They do give you the option to choose 32-bit, but you wouldn't really wanna do that for reasons we can get to in a bit. But if you do wanna check that, just to be sure, you can check in the system properties of Windows and look, it should say either 32-bit or 64-bit. Now, even though I did say that there's pretty much an unlimited amount of RAM that you can have with the 64-bit processor, Windows does implement limitations that are software limitations, and it does depend on which version of Windows you have, so this might be interesting to some of you. So when it comes to Windows 7, you might not have known this, but if you have the home version of Windows 7, you can only have up to 16 gigabytes of RAM. There's a limit on that. And if you have the pro version though, you can have up to 192 gigabytes. And this is just a software limitation. It's not a physical limitation that's impossible. Though when it comes to Windows 10, there's not really any realistic limit that anyone should worry about. Windows 10 Home, for example, has 128 gigabyte limit. So I don't know anyone who has 128 gigabytes. I don't even know if you could fit that in if you wanted, unless it was a server. Although, if you do have the pro version of Windows 10 or Enterprise or Education, then you can have 2 terabytes plus. So most people, I don't think, are gonna have to worry about RAM limitations on Windows 10. You can just stick as much as you want in there. Now, if you do happen to be installing Windows anytime soon and you have the choice between 32-bit and 64-bit, you definitely wanna go for 64-bit. There used to be issues with manufacturers not having drivers, and sometimes a lot of programs wouldn't work, you had to wait for it, but now that pretty much everyone has it, all manufacturers are making 64-bit drivers, so you don't have to worry about that, you're not gonna have any issues. Though one thing you should keep in mind is when you upgrade Windows, not necessarily a clean install, typically Windows will keep the same version through that upgrade. So if you have a 32-bit version of Windows and you do an upgrade, it's gonna give you a 32-bit version of the next edition of Windows. So if you've been upgrading Windows since Windows XP or something where you had 32-bit, you might wanna check, you might still have Windows 32-bit because you never did a clean install. And if that is the case, then you will have to do a clean install, which is kind of a pain in the neck. You have to do a reformat typically. So that's annoying, but you will get some benefit if you have more than 4 gigabytes of RAM. If you don't, then it's not really necessary, but you still might want to. You might be wondering, well, are there any disadvantages to running 64-bit Windows or programs? And the answer is kind of, I guess, but it's only in the sense of compatibility, because if you're running 64-bit Windows, then you might be using a really old device that doesn't have 64-bit drivers, and in that case, if you need that device, it's absolutely necessary for your livelihood or something, then it wouldn't make sense to upgrade, obviously, because you wouldn't be able to use it. And another disadvantage is if you have 64-bit, then you might not be able to run 16-bit programs on Windows 64-bit. It can run 32-bit programs fine, but not that far back. But I don't even know any examples of 16-bit programs that anyone would need if you're using like ancient software. Again, that could be a reason to stick to 32-bit, but I don't think that's gonna be for many people. So we talked about a 64-bit processor, 64-bit operating system, and of course you probably know that there are 32-bit and 64-bit programs that run on these operating systems. And some of you might be thinking, now wait a minute, if 64-bit is so great, then why are there so many 32-bit programs still around? And that is the case. Like, if you didn't notice, when you go into Windows on a 64-bit version, then there will be 2 folders for program files. There's gonna be program files, there's nothing on the extension, that's 64-bit programs, and then there's another one that'll be called program files x86, which is where all the 32-bit programs go. And obviously this does mean that you can run a 32-bit program on Windows 64-bit, no problem. Microsoft was sure to make sure that there would be no issues because pretty much all programs were written in 32, and it would not be very good if everyone's programs just didn't work anymore. So realistically, running a 32-bit program versus a 64-bit program, you're probably not gonna notice any difference. The difference would be that a 32-bit program can only use up to 4 gigabytes of RAM, whereas the 64-bit could use as much as you need. So the reason there are still so many 32-bit programs is a lot of developers, they might say, look, my program is very small, it definitely doesn't need 4 gigabytes of RAM, so I may as well just write it in 32-bit and then it'll work on everyone's computers, 32-bit or 64-bit, rather than writing 2 separate programs that no one's gonna know the difference. They have to compile it separately, there might be changes they have to make in the code, and it's like, like, it's not worth the hassle. There's not going to be any difference. So they just write it in 32-bit and are done with it. However, in general, if you do have the choice, it probably is better to install the 64-bit version of the program. It might run a little bit more efficient, especially if it does need more than 4 gigabytes of RAM, then you definitely want to run it, obviously, if you can take advantage of it. And also, you do get a little bit more of those security features that we talked about before. So it'll integrate better with that patch protection, and it'll just run better in general. If you do have the choice, you may as well run the 64-bit program. But a lot of times, it might not be obvious where to download this. They might just have you download the page by default to 32-bit, and they kind of make you search for the 64-bit version. But I mean, if you really look for it, usually most programs these days do have about 64-bit programs. So yeah, I guess there's not much more to say about it. The conclusion is what I just said. If you have the choice, go with 64-bit, unless you have something super duper old that won't work otherwise. If you guys have any ideas of your own, something I forgot to talk about, you can let me know down in the comments. If you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can just click on those. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. And also be sure to enable notifications by clicking the bell next to the subscribe button. So, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys again. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.